actually well before that. Well before that, yes. So things were very successful from that point, exactly. Yes.
Like the hospital sleep and you know the talking on the bathroom.
Right.
Did they seem to appear in the same places all the time or in different places?
Well, with this one, I know that field has never had anything in it like this before, allegedly. I asked around and the people who live in that area said, I've never seen anything like that, and just the wind. Well, Englands absolutely have. Those are reoccurring.
In the same spots?
Absolutely. Absolutely. People reference sacred sites, and they tend to come down very close to that. The formations we have in the United States are situated near ancient Native American sites, whether they're burial sites, ley lines. To be honest, this field on the corner of Gilbert and Ocotillo was no exception. That irrigation system at that field was actually the ancient, it was a Hohokam irrigation, and that is adjacent to that field. So, what does it mean? And usually when I say that, people, what does that mean? And so, it's, you know, there's really neat energy from prehistoric times, and they're just gravitating towards that energy. We don't know, but the correlations are high. Again, it happens in England all the time. In Ohio, it's always a circuit mound. There's a lot of things that go on in that area. But where you find formations and activity, do a little research on the outskirts, and there's something substantial with a historical site that goes along with it.
I think given that the challenges that you talked about that everybody's going through right now and the consciousness raising, I think it just came to me that one of the simple messages that those crop symbols might be giving us is bent but not broken.
Wow.
It's kind of a cool message.
That's very good. That's very good. And that's how many times we've been at that in our lives. I think a lot of us are in that situation now, like you said.
Oh, yeah.
We're being challenged every day. And we're being called upon to keep a level head and move forward. I know at this point I am. I know that folks know what I'm talking about there. You know, when it seems it's darkest, that's when we have to call upon something. Not necessarily outside of ourselves, but we can use that to muster up inside of us. Because everything we need is already within us. We already have the answers. I think most of you know that. It's here. We already have it. We just have to dig it out a little bit. A lot of these things make us do that. Do you have another question?
Yeah, I was wondering if you had any idea of why the crop circles in England are very geometric, circular, or other geometric symbols, which no one would think that wind would make. Why in Chandler is this event of a different nature so that it can be discounted by anybody as wind or why? What would be the explanation for that?
You're speaking of just the randomness?
Randomness of it, yes.
You know, that's a very good question. I've thought about that a lot. Actually, and to touch upon that, unfortunately, the woman who did an interview with me, Edith Jensen, and I think she put it in the story, she, before the presentation even started, she heard me and some people joking about things like that, well, bad thing to do around the media. She printed that the true circle makers are, because it was so ugly looking compared to those, they're practicing in Chandler in hopes to one day make it in the UK. And of course that got a laugh just like the UK is a trainee.
Well, that was little league in Chandler.
Exactly. So, you know, I can't answer that with a good answer, but the one thing that I kind of hold on to, and without looking at the actual geometry of it, is we know beyond the shadow of a doubt that whatever is responsible for the pretty ones is responsible for even the ones that look like this that you would call otherwise. It's the same thing. And I try not to get lost in the exterior of it. I mean, you'll see some that are just god-awful. You'll see circles that look like, you know, they were blindfolded, drunk, and in the middle of the night you try to do it. But then you do the testing, and it's like, gee whiz, it pans out. I mean, there's the same anomalies in this as that. So it's interesting.
If you didn't see it from the air, how do you know it was just right in the middle of
the... I would say that's a very good point. I would say. Now, the one in Tulsa, actually, an aerial view, it looked very much, I don't know if anybody saw that one from the aerial view. It looked side by side like ancient cuneiform, the rose. Stephanie Phelps, I believe is her name. If you go Google her name, I mean, it was almost identical. And that probably looked the same from the ground as well. Probably didn't look very good. So that's a very good point. Yes?
Do you know what percentage of these are found near ancient sites? And the ones that don't seem to be, how far back has the history gone looking? Is
right.
The possibility of a matter that this may be new to us, but we may not be new to that?
That's true. You know, as far as a percentage goes, I would say as much as, and I'll speak for the United States, 80% that I've researched have been by ancient sacred sites, which is astronomical. From Washington State to Ohio, for whatever reason, Ohio is big. Ohio has a lot of formations there a year.
Is that to make us beg the question, how did this intelligence know?
Absolutely. I've tried to steer myself into that direction many times. The sacred sites, what is it? Why? What's so big about it? Well, a lot of the sacred sites are situated, I mean, purposely on ley lines. The ancients knew where the chakras, so to speak, of Mother Earth were located. The ancients knew that. We're the ones who are going, oh, I wonder if. Or you gotta go back to the past to find the answer for the future. I mean, they're already there. So maybe that's the next place I'll go. You know, because I seem to get asked that question all the time, and I seem to say the same thing because I haven't gotten any more with the sacred sites. But again, the correlations are high, and we have to you know, give that research and the time.
Yes. Do you know if Google Earth could possibly look into past records of aerial satellite photographs and see what actually possible messages from above?
Yeah, actually, you know, and it's funny you say that because there are some that, for lack of a better word, are blanked out. There are some that you just can't get to, and the coordinates are not there. But others, they're fine. So, I mean, I think that would be a great tool if they allow us to get there. It's kind of like your, you know, Stanton Friedman's documents. You know, Freedom of Information Act, absolutely, it's our right. Well, when we get the documents, they're all blacked out. They say, oh, we sent you the documents, that's your right, but we're going to do this first. So I think that kind of goes along the same lines as that as well. So, good question. Good question, yes.
I just had a little bird on my shoulder. That came, one of the things that we need to be really aware of and keep in touch with our spirit, you're doing it through meditation things, we are too, as people of faith, is that the other souls in that other world know all about this. They're experiencing, and they're trying to prepare us. So it's all related.
And that's
in a spiritual way.
And that's true, and that's all reoccurring is it's all related. everything that, every topic that you can think of in this room right now, from the Phoenix lights to, I think you have some experience in that. Everything, crop formation, you name it, you're right, it's all related. But you know, we all have a piece of the puzzle. And that's why we're together, put it all together. How we doing, Jim? Okay. All right. I thank you very much. Appreciate it.